Macros are essentially used for repetitive processes, and this power of repeating is achieved with the use of loops. The most commonly used loops in VBA are for loop, do until, and do while loop. In this session, I will explain you about the use of for loop with 9 different examples. There is a bonus tip for the viewers, which is nothing but a rarely used shortcut in Excel. For loop is used when we know the exact number of iterations to be done. Suppose we need to add 5 new sheets to our workbook. I will create a macro for that. Go to Visual Basic Editor, insert a module. For loop example 1. The syntax of for is like, the keyword is for. Then we have to specify a variable. Here I will be using I, and then the starting value of I. Here it will be 1 up to 5. Because we need to execute the loop 5 times. Then the statement inside the loop, we have to add worksheets here. So worksheets.add. Then for closing the loop, next I. Let's execute the macro. You can see 5 sheets are added. I will show you an example for printing message using for loop. Go to Visual Basic Editor, insert a module. Let it be for loop example 2. Again 4, then a variable, let it be j equal 1 to. I will be printing the message 3 times, so I will be using 3 here. Then the statement for printing the message. Message box, for loop example, double quotes, then next j. Let's execute the macro, for loop example 2, run. So for loop example is our message, and the message will be displayed 3 times, 1, 2, 3. And if you want to know the value of j for each iteration, I will change the code. I'm copying this, let it be example number 3, iteration number ampersand j. Execute the macro, iteration number 1, 2, 3. I will explain the code using this debug mode option. Step into, press F8. The control came up to the loop, again F8, and you can see the value of j is 1 here, and when we press F8, message box will be displayed. And the message will be for loop example iteration number 1. I am pressing F8. You can see for loop example iteration number 1. Okay. And again press F8. And when we press F8, value of j will become 2. And here you can see value of j is 2. The next message will be for loop example iteration number 2. I am pressing F8. For loop example iteration number 2. Again F8. For loop example iteration number 3. And when I press F8, the control will go out of the loop because it is written j equal 1 to 3. The loop has to execute 3 times. When the value of j is 3, the control should go out of the loop. I'm pressing F8, control came to end of the program. And when I say we should know the number of iterations in advance to use the for loop, that doesn't mean we have to hard code the values inside the loop. We can accept values into variables from either an input box or a cell in our worksheet. So first we will see how to receive value from a sheet into the loop. So we will be receiving values from this particular cell B1 and B2. First value will be the number of iterations to perform. Then second value will be the message to be displayed. Insert a module, let it be for loop example 4. Here I will be declaring 2 variables as integer, then one more variable as string, that is for displaying the message. So whatever we write in B2 will be displayed as a message, and the number of iterations will be as per the value in B1. For receiving the number of iterations, j equal range B1 dot value. Then for the message, k equal range b2 dot value. Now our loop, for I equal 1 to j. Now message box space k, because k is the variable which we use to store the value in cell b2, and b2 will be having the message to be displayed. Next, I want the message to be displayed 4 times, and the message will be for loop example. Let's execute the macro for loop example 4, and you can see for loop example, and it will be displayed 4 times, 2, 3, and 4. And if you want to know the value of I in that particular iteration, use ampersand double quotes, one more ampersand I. Execute the macro for loop example 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now about receiving values from an input box and performing the iterations accordingly. Insert a module. I will copy this code. Let it be example number 5. Here I will use an input box. Input box. Enter the number of iterations to perform. Now one more input box for the message. Enter the message to be displayed. Across for loop example 5, enter the number of iterations to perform. I will use 5 here. Then message to be displayed. For loop example using input box. This will be my message. Okay. For loop example using input box 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now about the value of increment, otherwise counter for loop. You have seen every time the value is increasing by 1, and that is because the default value of increment in for loop is 1. And we can define the value of increment using the keyword step. Let's see how it works. I will write a macro for printing values from 1 to 21 into our worksheet. Insert a module. For loop example 6, step 1. Declare a variable I as integer. Next statement, range C3.select. That is the cell from which we will start printing this particular cell. Then the for loop. For I equal 1 to 21. Then active cell dot value equal I. To shift the control downwards, active cell offset 1, 0.select. Next, let's execute the macro. You can see the numbers from 1 to 21 is printed starting from the cell C3. Now I will change the increment to the value of 2. I'm copying this code. The next printing should start from E3. So cell to start with, it should be E3. Then here, step 2. Let's execute the macro. And here you can see 1, 3, 5 up to 21. That is because for each iteration, value of I will be increasing with an increment of 2. I will explain the code using this debug mode option. Step into F8. Here you can see value of I is 1. And again press F8. And now next I, F8, now the value of I is 3, that is the value of I increased from 1 to 3. Now when I press F8, value of I will become 5, and 5 is printed, again 7, and it goes on up to 21. And when the value of I is 21, the control should go out of the loop. And one more time. Step 3. Now I will use this G3 to start printing. G3. Before that, increment. Here I will change it to 3. Execute the macro. And this counter need not be always a positive value. We can use negative counter for decrementing the values. Now we will see the example for negative increment. I'm copying this macro and will change it for printing values from 100 to 80. So I equal 100 to 80 and step minus 1. So it should be printed in cell J3. Execute the macro. Example 7, step 1. Run. You can see values are printed from 100 to 80 with a decrement of 1. And now for the decrement of 2, and it should start from L3. I will copy this code, copy, insert a module, step 2, here 2, L3, macros, run. And you can see the values are printed with a decrement of 2, 198 up to 80. One more time. I'll copy this code, insert a module, 3, N, 3, so it's done. I told you about a bonus tip at the starting of the video, and this shortcut is exactly that bonus tip. If you want to enter the same formula into a number of cells at different locations, then select those cells pressing Ctrl key, enter the formula. Then holding the Ctrl key, press enter button, and you can see the formula is copied into all those selected cells. I hope you are now clear with the concept of for loop in VBA for Excel. For discussions and feedback, please make use of the comment section. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. If you want to get notified at the same time when I release a video, please hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon.